Hi, it's Ina. Welcome to my channel for authors, coaches, entrepreneurs, and anyone who wants to grow their business and their influence by being a guest on podcasts and by publishing content consistently. Video became a part of a marketing strategy of a lot of brands. There is live video, raw video, edited video. Video is everywhere. And I strongly suggest making video a part of your strategy. What do we need to film and publish videos nowadays? Well, not much. All my YouTube videos have been filmed with an iPhone XS, including this one. So it's not even an iPhone 11, it's XS. And the quality is pretty good. I love it. But there are a few tips and a few tools that I'd like to share with you today to up-level your iPhone filming game. There are a lot of tools that could up-level our phone filming game. There are lenses and lights and so many other toys, but I would recommend that you guys invest in three things to significantly improve the quality of your phone filming videos. So the first thing I recommend you guys get is a lavalier mic. I'm actually using it right now, so I'm going to come closer to show it to you. And it's this tiny microphone that attaches to your phone. You can also get it wireless, and it makes such a difference, especially if you film in a noisy environment. Like here, I have some neighborhood noises. I'm sure you heard some birds before in my videos, a dog barking, but thanks to this lavalier mic, the sound, my voice is more condensed, and it makes it for a better quality of a video. The second thing to get would be this little ring light. So it has a few settings and it's very easy to be charged. You could get it on Amazon. By the way, I'm gonna leave the link to all the gear down below. So I would strongly recommend it if you guys film in a low light environment. Of course, it's not gonna make it for a huge change because it's a small light, but it will make a difference. Now, the third tool I would recommend is this tripod that becomes actually a selfie stick. Again, I'm using it, so I have to take it off. And you could make it longer, shorter, and it comes with a tiny remote. Remote is also a good thing to have if you want to film or shoot some selfies. So the lavalier mic, the ring light, and the tripod that extends to a selfie stick with a tiny remote are the three things that I would recommend you guys get to up-level your phone filming game. I have three more tips to share with you to make our iPhone filmed videos look more professional. And it is composition, light, and flow. Composition. As you noticed, I'm including a lot of room here, and this is on purpose because this is where my editor will be including words and GIFs, things that will make this video easier to watch. Now, I am not including a lot of room here because I want my hands to be visible. It's just easier to watch and easier to follow. Now, if I was going to include a lot of room, I would probably look like this and it would not be as easy to follow because you would not be able to see my hands, right? Okay, I'm going back up. So this was composition. Besides composition, it's important to pay attention to lighting. Phones are very sensitive to lighting. So I chose 6 o'clock to film because I knew that the lighting is going to be perfect. Now, if I was going to film inside, I would check out at what time the lighting is perfect. So we have composition, lighting, and now the flow. So the flow is not so much about the iPhone filming, but it's more about editing. Strong editing can make for a good video. So making sure that the video just moves fast, is dynamic, it's engaging, is very important because that's what makes us captivated and that's what makes us want to watch more. Today I shared with you three things to get to up-level your iPhone filming game. The lavalier mic, the little ring light and the tripod that extends to a selfie stick with a little remote. The remote is actually really cool. It makes taking selfies easier. And then I share with you three other tips of how to make our iPhone filming better. It was all about the composition, the lighting, and the flow. And now I have an extra tip for you guys, and it's called give yourself a second. So when we start filming and press record, let's give ourselves a second before we start talking. And same thing when we finish, let's give ourselves a second before we stop recording. This will make the editing process way easier. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe for more tips on social media, guest podcasting, how to grow your business and your influence. And I will see you guys next time.